Hi, it's Jonathan again from Ripple Marketing. We're now into February, so we've finished our January month, which the theme was networking. We're now moving on to February, which we're kind of going to start talking about planning, so planning for the rest of the year. Over the next few videos, we're going to talk about the things that you need to be thinking about when planning, leading up to building it all together so that at the end of February you've got a cohesive marketing plan for the next short term and long term. The first one that I want to talk about is your avatar, your customer's avatar. And an avatar is your, if you like, your ideal client. So why is it important to have an ideal client down on paper? Quite simply, you want to focus your marketing activities. You want to focus what you're doing and making sure that it's going to hit your right customers, the customers that you want. Three very quick tips for identifying your avatar, or four. Number one, put it down on paper. Get a big piece of paper, get a table, get some of your team together and talk it over. Different people will have different ideas of your avatar. And don't be fooled into thinking you just have to have one avatar. I've got probably five ideal clients that we've got down on paper that we know pretty much everything about. So try to keep it down to a small number. As I said, we've got five, no problem. Most companies will have two, three, four, five. It's when it gets to much more than that that it starts to become difficult to focus your marketing activities. So number one is talk it over. Number two is give them a name, give them a face. Even as far as printing out someone's face from the internet and sticking on a picture of a body, visualizing it and you know, calling it, this is Frank, and you know, putting someone's head on it. So visualize it, put someone's face on it, give it a name, give it a face. It does help, and it helps you identifying you when you're referring to it later on. The final one is give them a story, write a story around them. So put yourself in their position. So one of our avatars is, let's say as an example, is Melissa. Melissa is a startup from a few years ago, is now coming back and realized that some of the things weren't done properly, so now coming back and doing it properly. Big ideas, spends a certain amount of time online, a certain amount of time looking at Facebook or Twitter or some of these. So we're really, really starting to get very specific about the things that they're doing and writing a bit of a story around them. Put yourself in their shoes, even do this kind of thing. Be interviewed as though you're that person. It really does help, and by identifying them, writing a bit of a story around them and putting a face to them, it really helps you identify with them and start to explore issues that they would have or where they would start to look at your marketing. Remember, the focus behind all of this is focusing yourself so that you know your marketing is going to work for your ideal client. So that's your avatar. Takes a bit of time. Get a piece of paper, put it down, talk it over, put a face to it. Next time we'll talk about the next part of creating your plan. And again, towards the end of the month, we'll start putting all of these things together. But your ideal client is really, really critical.